Today, I am going to give you a demonstration of maxillary central incisor, and this is the wax block I am using. So, I am going to mark the crown length approximately. Millimeters, then followed by the root, okay. Then we are going to mark the labial, mesial, palatal and distal surfaces. Then coming to the labial surface, we are going to mark the occlusal divergent crown shape like this. Then we will start reducing the wax from the distal and mesial surface of the tooth. Okay, we'll give a deep notch like this, followed by the removal of the wax. You can see now this side will get the occlusal divergence of the crown. Similarly, on the mesial side, we are going to give a deep notch like this and followed by the removal of the wax. Now clearly you can see the occlusal convergent surface. Okay, then coming to the labial side, we are going to mark two lines separating incisor 1/3, middle 1/3 and the distal 1/3. And coming to this side, we are going to give the midline mark and 1 mm mark towards the labial side. So then we'll start reducing the wax from the labial side in two planes. One is incisal plane and one is cervical plane. We have reduced the wax in the incisal plane. Then followed by the cervical plane. This is why, because we want to get the crest of the crown on the labial side, the junction of middle and the cervical 1/3. Okay, coming to the wrinkle side, similarly we should mark the three lines and we start reducing the wax from the wrinkle side towards the midline, which is given on the incisor surface. frequency, you have reduced the wax on the palatal surface. Okay. Then followed by the removal of wax in the cervical region and just rounding off this side because I want to get the palatal convergence and round cingulum shape. On the palatal side to get the structure of the tooth neatly. Now you can see the structure of tooth approximately. Rounding out the margin just a little. You should not have a sharp margin edges and sharp margins from the labial or lingual side. Then I am giving a proper lingual bulge. See now. Okay. Then we will start carving root part. Okay. We are drastically reducing the wax around the root part. We can easily remove the wax by applying pressure on the carved side of the carver. Like this. See how reduced the wax around the tooth. Then I am going to reduce wax so that I can get taper appearance towards the apex of the tooth. Okay. Then adjusting the shape of the crown like this so that I can reduce a little occlusal divergence. Then I am going to mark the cervical line. Semi-lunar shape towards the root apex. The mesial and distal side, it is in the opposite direction. The semilunar shape is towards the incisal edge. See, now you can see the markings clearly, and followed by removal of the bags around the cervical region so that I can get prominence. Clear cut cervical line. this, you can clearly get the cervical region. Okay, from the crown side also we are doing the same thing. We are reducing the wax towards the cervical region so that we will blend it smoothly. Initially, the cervical prominence and all the sides of the teeth. So finally, we got the shape of the tooth. Then we are going to give finishing details like W shape notch on the palatal surface of the tooth. Like that. So that we can preserve the marginal ridges here and here. We are going to round off the distal incisal edge like this. You can see that the mesial end is sharper than the distal end. Can you make it out now? Okay. Then we are going to elevate the root apex on the distal surface of the tooth. For that we are removing the wax on the distal surface of the wax block like this. Followed by shaping the root. So we are removing more wax from the root surface so that we can reduce the work towards the cervical region. Okay, like holding like this and remove the wax like this. See here, I am giving a little distal curvature to the root so that it will give a natural appearance, because all the tooth roots are still curved towards the distal side. Okay, then I am going to give notch on the root surface. The is a depression generally found on the distal side of the root surface. Can you see that, the depression? Okay. Then the carving of the tooth is finally done. Then when we are going to polish the tooth. Okay. We are going to take a little cotton and we will start doing polishing. While polishing, don't hold the teeth on the base like this. If you are holding here and applying pressure here, if you are applying pressure here, the crown is going to break off. Be careful, take your time. We are not going to lose the whole effort what we have done to cover the teeth. Take your time. There is no emergency, there is no urgency here. Then we are going to polish it slowly on each and every surface of the tooth and the root. I think you cannot clearly see the maxillary right central incisor with a curved distal end and a sharp mesial edge, double shaped notch with the preserved marginal ridges, root surface, root apex, and well demarcated marginal ridges, cervical line, and completely elevated root apex. I have given all the details to the tooth. If you want, you can make little more polishing carefully so that we are not going to break the tooth from the base. Okay. So you can see the lingual singular prominence clearly here. Okay. Thank you.